पिंडम हरकाय सूर्य कोटि सौप्रभ निर्विघ्न उत्तम देव सर्वकाशु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे काम रूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाय संतुप्तौ वागर्थ प्रतिपत्ते जगत पितरौ वंदे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ येनाक्षर समाम्नायमधिगम्य महेश्वरात् विष्णुं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनेय नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च पञ्चसूत्रयं धातुर्ब्रह्मैव सम्प्रोक्तो जीवाख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृति सुबन्ताय धातुर्महात्मने नमः। व्याकरण पाठ संभव संस्कार श्रुतिश्रुति पुराणानाम आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तिदक्षिणामूर्ते नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। ब्रह्माणुजातिगुरुवेदाश्च प्रणोतिवै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आम्नायन्ते संसिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनमापुरम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। सो टुवर्ड्स् दि एण्ड् आफ् दि रिफ्यूटेशन् आफ् बौद्धपक्ष इन्ट्रोड्यूसिङ्ग् दि 31st सूत्र इन् दि सेकेण्ड् पाद् आफ् दि सेकेण्ड् अध्याय दि वृत्ति सेस् ननु अहमिति आलयप्रत्यय एव आश्रयः इत्यतः। इन दि अर्लियर सूत्र न भावोनुपलब्धे दि सूत्रकार एट सेड दैट वासनानां सद्भावः नास्ति कुतः बाह्य पदार्थानां अनुपलब्धे बिकॉज बाह्य पदार्थाज आर नॉट देयर देयरफॉर दे कैन नॉट लीव वासनास इन दि केस ऑफ दि बौद्धास वेयर बाय दि वासनास कुड देमसेल्व्स कॉज a trigger as per the earlier sutra vaidharmya. So vaidharmya like swapna is possible due to vasanas in the jagrat avastha, says the Buddha, which was refuted by saying in your case vasanas themselves are not there. Why? Because bahya padarthas are not there, whereby the anubhav of the bahya padarthas leave the vasanas. In your case, vasanas are not possible because the bahya padarthas are not there, anubhava is not going to be possible, therefore samskaras or vasanas are not going to be possible. Therefore, vasana vaichitriya causing the pratiti vaichitriya in jagrat avastha is not possible. Now, the Purvapakshi says that, oh, we have something called as, just like you have aham pratiti, meaning aham vritti, and then you have idam vritti. Similarly, we have aham alaya, that alaya vijnana, which is called as aham pratyaya. Similar, but it is a vritti. Even if you agree that it is the same, let's for simplicity sake, let's just say aham vritti and idam vritti in the siddhanta is comparable. The aham vritti, we are just focusing on the aham vritti. The aham vritti, which is an ahankara, basically it is ahankara. So that ahankara comes up by aham vritti, that I am there, and it is pervading everything. In the siddhanta, aham vritti is pervading everything. Aham, without aham vritti, nothing can be understood. Therefore, in statements, not only in statements like I am doing something or I did this, you are talking to someone by I being the part of the statement. Not only in such cases, but even in cases when somebody is discussing, second person and third person are talking, you are a witness there. That sakshi to those, even if you describe that kind of a discussion, if you discuss, or if you, let's say, narrate or you are telling others of this discussion between Devadatta and Yajnayatta, where you are not a participant, you are just a witness. But when you are narrating that to someone else, saying that Devadatta said this to यज्ञरत था, देयर आई इज नॉट इंक्लूडेड इन द स्टेटमेंट. वेयर आई इज इंक्लूडेड इन द स्टेटमेंट, देयर इट इज ईजी टू सी दैट अहम वृत्ति एग्जिस्ट. बट इवन इन द केस वेन यू आर टेलिंग समवन एज टू देवरत्ता सेड दिस टू यज्ञरत्ता, देयर ऑल्सो विदाउट अहम वृत्ति दैट स्टेटमेंट इट्सेल्फ इज नॉट पॉसिबल. नॉट ओनली साक्षित्वम ऑफ दैट स्टेटमेंट बट टू नरेट ऑल्सो यू हैव टू बी देयर. So when you are saying that Devadatta said this to Yajnaratta, that aham is included as to I was the witness there and therefore I know that what he said, Devadatta said to Yajnaratta. And even now while saying it, I am saying this is known, because every statement is also manapurvakam. Manapurvaka, the statement, when you are making that statement, that time I am going to say this is a vritti which is going to be there, and I is included while making the statement also. Similarly, the Bauddhas have this aham vritti, they call it as alaya vijnana or alaya pratyaya. So the Purvapakshi says samskara may not be there. The last statement in the vritti in the earlier sutras, tvatpakshe vasananam samskara abhidhananam ashraya asambhava. Ashraya not being possible, therefore even if we hypothetically accept that samskaras are possible in some way, but where will they rest? Even if they are possible, they have no resting ground, therefore vasanas are not possible. Adhara abhavat, ashrayasya abhavat, adharasya abhavat, there the पूर्वपक्षी बौद्ध सेज अहम इति आलय प्रत्यय आश्रय, दैट अहम प्रत्यय कैन बी आश्रय, देयर बाय वासनास कैन कंटिन्यू टू बी देयर एंड दीज विल ट्रिगर द प्रतीति ऑफ द विषयाज आउटसाइड इन द जागृत अवस्था. हाउ अबाउट दैट? टू दैट द सिद्धांति सेज क्षणिकत्वाच न शुड बी ब्रॉट डाउन फ्रॉम द अर्लियर सूत्र क्षणिकत्वाच. सो अहम इत्ये आलय प्रत्ययस्य क्षणिकत्वात्, दिस वृत्ति कम्स एंड गोज, एंड इन यूर केस एवरीथिंग इज क्षणिक, लेट अलोन वृत्ति. वृत्ति इज डेफिनेटली क्षणिक. सो हाउ कैन दैट आलय प्रत्यय विच इज अ वृत्ति एंड स्टे ओनली फॉर अ मोमेंट, विच स्टेज ओनली फॉर अ मोमेंट, हाउ कैन इट बिकम द आश्रय फॉर वासनास? फॉर एनीथिंग इट कैन नॉट बी आश्रय फॉर एनीथिंग. Therefore, क्षणिकत्वात् हेतोः च आलय प्रत्ययः वासनानाम् आश्रयः न. That is the सूत्रार्थः. वृत्ति इज वेरी शॉर्ट. आलय विज्ञानस्य क्षणिकत्व अंगीकारात् न आश्रयत्वम् इत्यर्थः. वेरी सिंपल सेइंग दैट बिकॉज आलय विज्ञान विच यू कॉल एज आलय प्रत्यय और इन अवर केस वी कॉल एज अहम वृत्ति, सिमिलर टू अहम वृत्ति, दैट कैनॉट बी द आश्रय बिकॉज इट इज मोमेंटरी. अधिकरण द्वयार्थम उपसंहरति. नाउ दी लास्ट टू अधिकरणास आर समड अप इन दिस लास्ट सूत्र एज टू सर्वथा अनुपपत्तेश्च, सर्वथा अनुपपत्तेश्च. सूत्रकार मेक्स अ कंक्लूजन ऑफ दी रिफ्यूटेशन ऑफ दी बौद्ध पक्ष बाय समिंग अप व्हाट दी लास्ट टू अधिकरणास. सर्वथा अनुपपत्ते है च, एंड ऑल्सो ड्यू टू वॉट फाइनली दिस बौद्ध पक्ष इज नॉट प्रमाण मूल, इट इज भ्रांति मूल. वाय सर्वथा अनुपपत्तेश, प्रकारवाची थल इज देयर, प्रत्यय सर्वथा. सर्वथा मीन्स इन ऑलवेज, इन एनी मैनर, इन एनी मैनर, इन ऑल मैनर्स, ऑलवेज अनुपपत्ते है. वॉट दे से इज नॉट टेनेबल, दैट इज द हेतु. Why? So sarvatha, what is sarvatha? So there the vritti looks into it as to their language is also asadhu, and conclusions also, because they are nastikas, that is also asadhu, therefore not tenable. You can imagine that this may be the case, and you can give a hypothesis. Unless it is refuted, it may stand as stand out as a darshana or a philosophy, but when you scrutinize, then it will fall apart. That is what we have done. We have shown that nothing that is a foundation or the main prakriya of these bodhas, nothing of that darshana is valid. Divritti says pashyana tishtana ityadi apashabda prayogat granthataha anupapannam idam matam. Then uktakramena arthata anupapannam eva iti sarvata anupapattehe. So what is the sarvata anupapatti? So granthata and granthata meaning shabdata. Shabda apashabda prayoga is there. Instead of saying pashyan tishtan ityadi or pashyati tishtati, they have used some asadhu language like pashyana tishtana in their grantha. So it is not Sanskrita also. So you do not know as to how should you trust some who are using or corrupting the language itself. So that's one way to look at it. As to the language itself is unclear, not worthy of putting your trust in it, let alone their tattva. So that is the sarvata extension into shabda prayoga also. So pashyana tishtana ityadi apashabda prayogat granthatha anupapanna vidam matam. The grantha can be set aside. Then the content of the grantha, which is the philosophy, what about that? Ukta kramena arthatha, that has already been refuted. So far, whatever the refutation went by in the sutras to counter the Bauddha Paksha and show that as not Pramana Moola but Bhranti Moola, Ukta Kramena, in the sequence that was mentioned, Arthata also. If you look at the meaning and the philosophical aspect, Anupapannam, that is also Anupapannam Eva. Indeed, it is not tenable. Iti Sarvata Anupapathe. In this manner, there is no way that it is tenable. The Bauddha Grantha, na adharaniyam, sarvata anupapatte, due to not being tenable in any manner, na adharaniyam, it should not be given any respect as a means to moksha, meaning as pramana, for any purpose. Whatever they are saying should not be taken as pramana. By whom? Shreyavartibhi. Those who want moksha should use the means to moksha which is valid. Therefore, pramana should be the basis for the sadhana to reach a sadhya. Shreyavarthis are those who want moksha, mukshus ityartha. So, by mukshus, Shreyavartibhi, bhranti moolam savagata matam iti siddham. So, Shreyavartibhi na adharaniyam, that is the anvaya, and then this saugata matam bhranti moolam iti siddham, that is the anvaya. So saugata mata, the bauddha mata, is bhranti moolam, it is not pramana moolam iti siddham. This is established by elaborate analysis and refutation. Sarva shunyavadi nirasa paratvena api etani na bhava anupalabdhe ityadi sutrani yojitavyani. Then as a homework, the vritti leaves the shunyavadi refutation to you. He says, whatever we have done so far with the Kshanika Vidyanavadins, so the Na Abhava Upalabdhe, so the last two sutras, Na Abhava Anupalabdhe and Kshanikatva, Na Abhava, it should not be Upalabdhe, Anupalabdhe, there is a typo there. Any moment. In the book itself, it is na abhava upalabdhe. Oh, so maybe you have to go back. Yeah, sorry. So 28th sutra. So na abhava upalabdhe is different from na bhava anupalabdhe. So na abhava upalabdhe. So from the 28th sutra onwards, 28, 29, 30 and 31 and 32, of course. So all these last five sutras are applicable to refute which have been used to refute the Kshanika Vijnana Vadins, can be extended to Shunya Vadins definitely, because Kshanika Vijnana itself does not stand scrutiny. How can the शून्यवाद बी वैलिड, दैट इज दी कैमुतिक न्याय यूज हियर एंड देयर बाय न अभाव उपलब्धि, देयर इज नो टाइपो हियर, आई टुक इट एज द रीसेंट सूत्र, इट एज गॉन बाय कपल ऑफ पाठ इन द लास्ट पाठ, इत्यादि सूत्राणि योजितव्यानि, दी शुड बी कनेक्टेड एंड देयर बाय दी सर्वशून्यवादी सर्वशून्यवाद ऑल्सो शुड बी रिफ्यूटेड एंड सेट असाइड, दैट इज ऑल्सो भ्रांति मूल नॉट प्रमाण मूल. नाउ द बौद्ध निराशा इज ओवर. नाउ द जैन पक्ष इज टेकन एंड हाउ इज जैन पक्ष कमिंग टू माइंड फॉर द सूत्रकार. सो फॉर दैट यू नो काइंड ऑफ इट सीम्स लाइक ए ह्यूमर. सो एवं मुक्तकच्छानां बौद्धानां मते निरस्ते सति मुक्तांबराणां मतं बुद्धिस्तम. सो हाउ डिड द जैन मत कम टू माइंड, बेसिकली जैनास केम टू माइंड, हाउ डिड जैनास कम टू माइंड ऑफ द सूत्रकार. सो देयर द वृत्ति इंट्रोड्यूसेस बाय सेइंग दीज बौद्धास आर दोज हू वेर दी वेष्टी इत्यादि, दे वेर क्लोथ्स बट दे डू नॉट वेर दी कौपिन कच्छ. सो मुक्त कच्छानां बौद्धानां मते निरस्ते, वेन देयर मता हैज बीन रिफ्यूटेड, सो यू नो दैट दे डोंट वेर कच्छ कौपिन, दे वेर अदर क्लोथ्स. नाउ दी जैनास डू नॉट वेर एनी क्लोथ्स, दिगंबरास. सो मुक्तांबराणां दोज हू हैव गिवन अप ऑल क्लोथ्स, देयर मत इज बुद्धिस्त. सो दिस इज हाउ दी अदरवाइज फिलोसॉफिकली देर इज नो कनेक्शन टू एक्सटेंड. सो ही सेज दैट बिकॉज बौद्धास हैव वेर अ पर्टिकुलर काइंड ऑफ और हैव अ मिसिंग क्लॉथ, वेर एज जैनास हैव नो क्लोथ्स, ऑल क्लोथ्स आर मिसिंग, दिगंबरा देव गिवन अप. बेसिकली इट इज ऑल वैराग्य. सो इट इज नॉट एन इंसल्ट पर से. So we should respect, we should not make philosophically you talk anything, but as Advaitins we should follow our sampradaya as to we do not insult the person. The idea can be refuted but the person should be respected. Of course, I mean in tarka there is style to insult in the tarka itself, that is insulting the buddhi, that's a tactic. So but otherwise, you know, their behavior and all that, if it is something worthy of respect, we should respect it. And thereby, Muktambaran, Digambaras. Digambaras have come to mind because it is an extension of dropping all clothes, that kind of vairagya they have, versus the Baudhas who wear clothes but they give up the, they do not wear the kaupina. Evancha buddhi sannidhi lakshana sangatya idamaha. So buddhi sannidhi, so because there is no sangati otherwise, there is no sangati to extend across these. The way Astika Darshanas, across Astika Darshankhyas and Tarkikas, there was a connection. Some sangati could have been seen. And across Nayayikas and Baudhas also, Ardha Vainashika and Vainashikas, Purna Vainashikas, that was the sangati seen. Now here across Darshanas, where Baudhas are also Nastika and Jainas are also Nastikas, but there is no philosophical connection there, or between darshanas there is no philosophical overlap. Therefore, some other way, I mean it can always be said that you know something else has to be taken up, therefore no sangati is needed, but some sangati is there, why jainas, why not something else. Therefore evancha buddhi sannidhi lakshana, because it is very close in not wearing one piece of cloth versus not wearing any clothes, that is you know it is there is sannidhi in the buddhi in this if you take dress into the account, then there is some kind of a sannidhi there, there is proximity in the two followers of two darshanas. So anyway, it is clear. I just was trying to buffer the usage of this kind of a sangati. Evancha buddhi sannidhi lakshana sangatya idam. So it is very clear that it has just come to mind, it is not an insult per se, and thereby the next adhikaran ekasmin asambhava adhikaranam. So ekasmin asambhava adhikaranam, देर इज असंभव, असंभव ऑफ द फिलोसॉफिकल एस्पेक्ट्स विच आर इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द जैन एज टू व्हाट इज दिस प्रपंच. दे ऑल्सो एग्री विथ आत्मा, दे से दैट देर इज एन आत्मा, बट देयर प्रमाणा इज नॉट वेदास, देयर प्रमाणा इज वॉट एवर देयर देयर आचार्यज हैव गिवन इन अ मेडिटेटिव स्टेट और वॉट एवर दैट कैंड ऑफ अ दर्शन. That kind of a darshana becomes the basis for darshana, meaning that kind of a vision that they had becomes the basis of their grantha, granthagata philosophy, darshana. So what they talk about, that all is not possible, all of that is impossible, asambhava in eka or simultaneously. It will be clear as we look at the sutra. So that is the adhikarana's name. The first sutra there, 33rd sutra, is naikasminna sambhavat, naikasminna sambhavat, na ekasmin asambhavat. Very clear, very clearly in keeping with the adhikarana title is the first sutra. That's how the many times that's how the name comes up with the sutra. The name for the adhikarana comes up. Na ekasmin asambhavat, na. किन्न एकस्मिन् विदु विरुद्ध धर्मान, द विरुद्ध धर्मास दैट दे टॉक अबाउट दे आर नॉट पॉसिबल. व्हाट आर दीज विरुद्ध धर्मास? सो लिटिल बैकग्राउंड देयर, इट विल बी सेड इन दी वृत्ति स्यादस्ति स्यान्नास्ति. सो व्हेन दे आर आस्ट इज दिस प्रपंच देयर, Buddha say it is not there, or it is there momentarily based on which kind of a Buddha. Now when you ask the Jainas as to what does your darshana say regarding this prapancha which is seen outside, cognized outside through all the sense organs, what is the status satta of this prapancha, they say it may be there, it may not be there. It may be there, may not be there. So these kind of contradictory statements are made by them. So they have syadasti. They say syadasti. What is syadasti? May be there. Then syannasti. Then syadasti cha nasti cha. This is the third paksha, meaning may be there, may not be there. These are the three which I explained in English anyway earlier. Now they say avyaktam, it is unmanifest. Then they combine the earlier three with the avyakta. So you have got four. Syadasti, syannasti, syadasti, cha nasti cha. Now the fourth one is avyaktam. Now this avyakta in combination with the earlier three will become three more pakshas. Syadasti cha avyaktam cha, syannasti cha avyaktam cha, स्यादस्ति च नास्ति च अव्यक्तं च. सो व्हाट डज इट मीन? दे से दे गिव सेवन आंसर्स. सर्वे पदार्थः युगपत् सप्त प्रकाराः, ऑल दीज पदार्थास इन द प्रपंच आर साइमल्टेनियसली ऑफ, साइमल्टेनियसली नॉट ऑफ सेवन टाइप्स, सप्त प्रकार दे आर साइमल्टेनियसली ऑफ सेवन टाइप्स. देयरफॉर यू कैन नॉट से दैट इट इज वन ऑफ दीज, इट इज ऑल ऑफ दीज एट द सेम टाइम. This is what they call it, Saptabhangi Nayam. So they call it as a system of seven types called as a Saptabhangi Naya. So in this Saptabhangi Naya, they say Syadasti, meaning Prapancha, Padar, all Padarthas may be there. Syannasti may not be there. Syadasti cha nasti cha, may be there, may not be there. Meaning are there and are not there simultaneously. They are unmanifest, fourth Paksha. Then they are Avyaktam. And may be there, they are unmanifest and may not be there. So they are unmanifest and may be there, they are unmanifest and may not be there, they are unmanifest and may be there, may not be there. And so this kind of a combination of seven, simultaneously all this is there in the padarthas. Now this should be contrasted with what we say about anirvachaniya. we say that it cannot be categorized into sat or asat. Then the Viveka Chudamani, Bhagavad Padacharya takes the possibility, he takes the possibility and immediately says it is not possible because of Virodha. What is the possibility? Is there a possibility of Prapancha being Sat as well as Asat? If it is not Sat, if it is not Asat, how about being Sat and Asat? He says that is not possible. Why? Virodha Dharma Vattvat. Because they are Virodha Dharma. One entity cannot have Viruddha Dharma simultaneously. At different times, different deshas or different kalas, it may be possible. But in the same desha and kala, simultaneously, Yugapat Viruddha Dharma Vattvam na sambhavati. Now, Jainas say that all of this Viruddha, everything is Viruddha there. All seven are contradictory to each other. Mutually contradictory to each other, all seven are mutually contradictory to each other. And they say all that is simultaneous. That itself is the basis of Bhranti Mula, the Mata being Bhranti Mula. But they say because we have a system, it is Pramana Mula. So, Sutra Artha is, na Ekasmin Asambhavat. The your Mata, Pramana, so you can also read as what? Jaina Darshana Mata is what? Digambara Mata is Bhranti Mula, not Pramana Mula, na Pramana Mulam. Why? Ekasmin Asambhavat. All these Saptapadarthas being available simultaneously, Yugapat, is not possible. Phalam Purovata, meaning the Samanvaya Siddhi, Samanvaya Asiddhi, or the Vedanta Mata being valid or invalid, meaning what? The Paramatma, who is not acceptable to Jainas, is the Jagat Karana as claimed by Siddhanti based on the Shruti, is not acceptable. There is a Virodha by Jaina Darshana, says the Purvapakshi Jaina. Whereas the Siddhanti says that Samanvaya Siddhi, and thereby Samanvaya Siddhi, like earlier, Bauddha Paksha refutation, we have seen this in the Bauddha Paksha refutation, that Samanvaya Siddhi by Shruti is for the Astikas. For the Nastikas, we say that Samanvaya is into Brahma, Parabrahma, Paramatma as Jagat Karana, which is not acceptable to Jainas. So, Jainas say there is a Virodha with their Darshana, and therefore there is a contradiction, and which is valid, our system is valid, yours is not. And we want to show that both systems cannot be valid. Although we trace our Darshana to the Shruti, Vedanta Darshana, even if you don't accept the Shruti as Pramana, you the Jainas, still what we are saying as Paramatma being Jagat Karana, that part, on that part we can have a debate. Since there can be no two contradictory philosophies which are right, therefore either your system is alright or mine is right. And this is the reason that the Jainas are shown to be Bhranti Mula. Jaina Darshana is shown to be Bhranti Mula, so that the Samanvaya that we have already shown for Astikas in Shruti, that stands tall, and the Darshana, Vedanta Darshana, without the Shruti as Mula being shown to the Nastikas also stands tall, stands irrefuted. So that is the phala. That is the reason we are, although we do not need to show that the other Darshanas have no foundation, we are doing that so that our Darshana remains strong in the minds of the Shreyavarthis or Mumukshus. So Digambara Matam, Jaina Matam, Digambara Matam, those who do not wear clothes due to Vairagya, Pramana Moolam, Bhranti Moolam, Vaiti Sandehe, Syad Asti, Syan Nasti, Ityadi Saptabhangi Nayam, Astitva Nastitvadi, Viruddha Dharma Dvayam Adaya, Sarveshu Padartheshu Yojayantaha Digambaraha, Padartha Matrasya Aneka Rupatvam Achakshata Iti, Tanmatam Pramana Moolam Iti Purva Paksha. Jaina say that our Mata is Pramana Moola. Why? They say that when there is a question as to whether it is pramana mula or bhranti mula, they say it is pramana mula. Why? Because they have a system called what syad asti, syan nasti, tyadi saptabhangi naya is there, which we just saw. So they have a system of seven simultaneously existent, we should not say existent also. Simultaneously, there are seven properties which are there as being existent, not being existent, being existent and non-existent together, unmanifest, etc. So astitva nastitvadi viruddha dharma, this syad asti and syan nasti, maybe it is there, maybe it is not there. Syat means maybe, but asti or nasti, may be there, may not be there. So that itself, astitva and nastitva, is and not, is not, they are all viruddha dharmas. So astitva nastitvadi viruddha dharma dvayam adaya, taking these opposing qualities all the way, sarveshu padarteshu yojanta, they say that although they are opposite properties, they are seen, and we have taken these opposite properties and shown them to apply in each and every padartha, in all padarthas. So you show it in a particular sample and extend it to others using tarka, samkalpita astitva nastitva, syad astitvam, syan nastitvam, syad astitvam nastitvam cha, avyaktatvam, all this that they have extended to the entire prapancha padarthas as simultaneously existing, yojayantaha digambara, those who are showing that these kind of properties pervade through the padarthas, padartha matrasya aneka rupatvam achakshate. They say that the same padartha, one padartha that you are asking, which is extensible to the entire prapancha, whether it is there or not, what is the satta, what is the status, what is the avastha of this prapancha, if you ask that, they say all of these sapta, bhangi, naya, antargata, dharmas, they are aneka rupa of each and every padartha simultaneously. So padartha matrasya, you take any padartha, they have all these seven simultaneously. Aneka rupato achakshite, they see this kind of a thing in their darshana and show it convincingly from their perspective. The saptamungi naya is very convincing for them. They think it is very convincing. It is not. It is illogical. Iti tanmatam pramana mulam iti purvapaksha. So they say that since we are able to show this viruddha dharma dvayas, taking this viruddha dharma dvayas being there, therefore this prapancha, if you ask me what it is, I have to say that all of these seven exist. He is not saying I cannot tell you, meaning it cannot be categorized. That is the Vedanta Paksha. Jaina Paksha is that I will tell you all these seven are there simultaneously. There itself it is falling apart, illogical. But they say since we can show this in our darshana, therefore it is pramana mula. We have, and it is not that we have seen one or two dharmas. We have analyzed seven dharmas. There is no eighth. So if you ask there is an eight dharma, there is no eight dharma. So there is some discussion and debate and analysis that has gone by across many generations, which is based on vision of our great acharyas, tirthankaras. So it is pramana mula. That is their case. Siddhantastu naikasmin asambhavat. Siddhantin says no, all that is not valid. Why? Ekasmin viruddha dharmanam asambhavat yugapat. So ekasmin paramatma rupe, so they say this vastu is actually paramatma rupa. Finally, when you say it is there in the prapancha, this viruddha dharmas, what are we really saying? From the siddhanti perspective, only paramatma exists. Whether you see it in one padartha or many padarthas, finally for our darshana it is all paramatma. In Paramatma, there is a bhranti of all of these viruddha dharmas. If you say bhranti is there of viruddha dharmas, we'll agree. May be there, may not be there, all this can be possible. It can even come to the discussion table only if you say it is an appearance. They don't say it is an appearance. Therefore, ekasmin paramatma rupe vastuni. परमात्म रूपे फॉर दी आस्तिक इट इज नॉट फॉर दी नास्तिक जैन एकस्मिन वस्तुनी वी आर सेइंग एंड सिद्धांती शिष्याज आर सिटिंग देर हु आर इंटरेस्टेड इन द डिबेट शिष्याज और सिद्धांती वेदांती फॉलोअर्स वेदांती श्रेयोअर्थीज आर देर मुमुक्षुस फॉर देम वृत्ति सेज परमात्म रूपे वस्तुनी दिस वस्तु इज वॉट वस्तु वसती इति वस्तु दैट विच एग्जिस्ट देर इज नो विरुद्ध धर्म पॉसिबल बिकॉज वसती इति वस्तु मीन्स अस्थि इफ यू से अस्थि एंड नास्ति च और स्यादस्ति इफ यू से देर इट्स विल फॉलो बट स्यादस्ति मीन्स मे बी देर यू से वसती इति वस्तु एंड देन यू से इन द व्यावहारिक सत्ता ऑल्सो यू इफ यू जस्ट से स्यादस्ति मे बी देर यू आर लुकिंग एट अ रोप वेदर इट इज स्नेक और नॉट यू कैन से मे और मे नॉट बी After knowing that it is, it may be snake, it may be rope. How? Because someone tells you that it is not snake. Oh, it is not snake, it may be a snake. Oh, it's a rope, someone says it's a rope, it may be a rope. That kind of a possibility is there only if someone is telling you that in that kind of a scenario. But you are saying only one thing and you are doing vyavahara every time. You don't have doubts all the time. In fact, one who sees Rajju as Sarpa, he has no doubt initially. So, in the transactory world, in this Vyavaharika Satta, in Vyavahara, you assume that what your Indriyas are telling you, that is right. So, all that is Pramana. Therefore, it is Pramana. Otherwise, all your analysis will also be questionable. Now, we can tell him, is your analysis part of this Prapancha or not? So prapancha itself is has no basis, meaning has all these opposing qualities, then your analysis also will have opposing qualities. That is a corollary which they don't seem to get to. Anyway, all that is, you know, when you are debating the details of the Jaina Paksha as to on what basis they came to this conclusion, there you can raise these doubts. But here, when you are talking about one single vastu having so many contradictory dharma, 7, not 1 or 2. So 7, totally 6 opposing one each. If you take any dharma, 6 will be standing opposed to it. So ekasmin vastuni, and for astika, that vastu is qualified by visheshana, paramatma rupe vastuni. Viruddha dharmana masambhavat. There is no possibility of viruddha dharmas being there. There is no possibility. वस्तुनः अनेक रूपत्वं नास्ति इत्यर्थः सो दिस नो फॉर सिंप्लिसिटी सेक वी कैन से दैट ओवरऑल वी कैन से दैट दिस जैन मता इज नॉट प्रमाण मूल व्हाई व्हेन यू गो टू डिटेल्स यू सी दैट वस्तुनः अनेक रूपत्वं न नास्ति इत्यर्थः दैट इज असंभव देयर यद अस्ति तद अस्ति एव न नास्ति इफ द पूर्व पक्षी सेज व्हाई डू यू से दैट इन वन वस्तु देर कैन नॉट बी अनेक रूप धर्म मीनिंग अनेक रूपत्व मीन्स व्हाट अनेक धर्मवत्व अनेक रूपत्व मीन्स अनेक धर्मवत्व हियर सो वन थिंग कैन नॉट हैव मेनी धर्मास अदरवाइज इट विल बी इन मेनी फॉर्म्स फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू एज एन असाइड इफ यू टेक घटत्व घटत्व एंड पटत्व आर टू डिफरेंट धर्मास एंड लेट से देर इज विरोधा बिटवीन घट एंड पट बाय अन्योन्य अभाव दैट इज व्हाट इज कॉल्ड एज भेद भेद मीन्स अन्योन्य अभाव घटे पटत्व नास्ति पटे घटत्व नास्ति सो देर बाय इफ यू सी भेद एंड विरोधा देर आई मीन फॉर सिंप्लिसिटी सेक आई एम सेइंग दैट लेट से देर इज अ विरोधा देर इफ घटत्व इज देर देन पटत्व कैन नॉट बी देर पटत्व इज देर घटत्व कैन नॉट बी देर One vastu can be either ghata or pata because there can be only ghatatvam or patatvam. Now, if you are saying viruddha dharma, so we are saying ghata pata vat. By that, we are arguing that they are viruddha dharmas. Can they be there? If ghatatva is there, then the vastu will become ghata rupa. If the patatvam is there, then vastu will become pata rupa. So that is the meaning of aneka rupatvam nasti. So ghata rupatvam asti. पटरूपत्वम नास्ति पटरूपत्वम अस्ति अस्ति चेत घटरूपत्वम नास्ति सो घटत्वम अस्ति देन पटत्वम नास्ति पटत्वम अस्ति घटत्वम नास्ति सेम मीनिंग एज टू अनेक धर्मवत्वम और अनेक रूपत्वम वाय सो युअर धर्म इज आर वॉट स्यादस्ति स्यान् नास्ति इत्यादि सो यद् अस्ति तदस्ति एव न नास्ति सो इफ यू से प्रपंच इफ यू टेक घट इफ आई आस्क यू घट अस्ति वा न वा जैना सेज दैट स्यादस्ति स्यान् नास्ति स्यादस्ति च नास्ति च इत्यादि सो यदस्ति इफ यू से स्यादस्ति देन आल से ओ घट स्यादस्ति अस्ति चेत तदस्ति एव इट इज ओनली इफ यू से इट इज एग्जिस्टेंट इट इज एग्जिस्टेंट इट कैनॉट बी न नास्ति इट कैनॉट बी नास्ति इट कैनॉट हैव नास्तित्व धर्म अस्तित्व इज देयर देन नास्तित्व कैनॉट बी देयर अनस्तित्व कैनॉट बी देयर अनस्तित्व कैनॉट बी देयर इफ अस्तित्व इज देयर सो यदस्ति तदस्ति एव न नास्ति दिस इज ऑल्सो वॉट सिमिलर टू युअर भाष्य इन रिफ्यूटेशन इफ यू लुक एट इट कैन सी द एक्सपांस इन The way we have refuted the Bauddhas also, the underlying shloka bhashya can be seen as to Gita bhashya on na bhav vidyate sataha, na abhavaha vidyate sataha, sataha abhavana vidyate, and vice versa. So yad asti itar asti eva, na nasti, yan nityam, tan nityam eva, na nityam. Virudha dharmas, nityam and anityam. So you say syad, you say asti and then you say syad also. If it is asti, then it cannot be syad also. There also there is virudha. So yan nityam, what is nitya cannot be anitya. It is nitya only. So eva should be read. Nitya and anitya, nityancha cannot be said. Nityam, yad nityam, tan nityam eva. Na anityam api. You cannot say anityam also. You cannot even say that is anityam only also. So that which is nityam is only nityam. It cannot be anityam, it cannot be anitya also. Yatha pratyagatma vastu bhutaha. Now this has been taken, this discussion to show that this vastu is finally atma, paramatma. They may not agree with this paramatma as revealed by the Shruti, but they say Atma is there. They agree with karma. They agree with Punarjanma. They say that, the Atma Swarupa is there. Some Swarupa is there. It is not like Kshanika of the Bauddhas. They talk about this Atma who is Nitya, who is continuing. Nitya Atma, who is Jivatma, will get karma phala across Janmas. He'll get that kind of sharira, all that they agree with. So therefore pratyagatma, the innermost atma, who is not the shariram but he is shariri, that pratyagatma, the innermost self, who is different from the koshas, that atma is vastu bhuta. If you say that the prapancha is like this, will you say the same thing about atma? Syadasti syannasti, you won't say. Syadasti, syannasti, that you have talked about the prapancha, but what about the atma, pratyagatma? Pratyagatma is vastubhuta. And being vastu, now this, just like pratyagatma, which is vastu, vasatiti vastu, existent, is existent alone, is not syadasti, syannasti, syadasti cha nasti cha. Similarly, this prapancha also you say asti or nasti or something like that. If it is nasti, we'll have a different discussion. But if you say that it has all of these seven contradictory dharmas, it is not possible. Otherwise, let it apply to Atma also. Does it apply to Atma? It doesn't. Similarly, this Viruddha Dharma Vattvam is not possible for Prapancha Vastu also. So, Pratyagatma Vastu Bhuta Yatha. Evam Prapanchasyapi Tvanmate Vastu Bhuta Tvat. And since you say that Prapancha is also Vastu, is in the form of vastu. Pratyagatma, which is vastu bhuta, prapancha is vastu bhuta. Pratyagatma being vastu bhuta is nitya and not anitya, is asti, meaning is. Prapancha is prapancha asti. Prapancha, which is being vastu, asti, na nasti. So pratyagatma, which is vastubhuta, sorry, pratyagatma, which is vastubhuta, being vastubhuta, it is very difficult to make a sentence construct without, you know, if I translate the asti and then use asti, then it brings a virodha in my own mind. So it is very difficult. I am trying to drop, I am trying to avoid more pathas in English for this very reason. However hard you try, still there is a delay in the patha. I have to repeat and correct myself many a time. So sorry about that. So yatha pratyagatma vastubhuta. So that is being extended. This vastutvam in pratyagatma is extended to prapancha padarthas also. They are also vastu, therefore they also have vastutvam. Now pratyagatma, the innermost self, which is vastubhuta and being vastubhuta, yatha nitya and not anitya, yatha asti and not nasti, so it is there and not there. Double negation. You cannot say it is not there. Atma. Similarly, evam prapanchasya api tvanmate vastu bhutatvat. In our paksha, we can't have such kind of argument. We'll give an anirvachaniya vada. But in your case, the Jainas, prapancha is what? Vastubhuta. Like pratyagatma, pratyagatma is vastubhuta. Then vastubhutattvam being a common claim in your darshana for atma, pratyagatma as well as prapancha, then how is it that pratyagatma is nitya asti, but prapancha is what? Prapancha is syadasti, syannasti, ityadi. Therefore, aneka rupatvam na. So, evam prapanchasya api tvanmate vastubhutatvat na aneka rupatva sambhava. Therefore, prapanchasya aneka rupatva sambhava nasti. It is not possible that prapancha will be aneka rupa. Why? Pratyagatma, which is also vastu like prapancha, is like prapancha is vastutvam only. We are talking about only vastutvam. Vastutvam is common, it is a vastu, but it is not aneka rupa. It is eka rupa. Asman matetu prapancha na sannasan. So if he says, well, what about your case? You also talk about prapancha, but then you say it is anirvachaniya. How about that prapancha is vastu? Like Atma is vastu in your case also. We say it is not so in our case. In our case, the only vastu is Brahmatma. So Asmanmate, if you make the same aropa in our Vedanta Siddhanta, Asmanmate tu prapancha na san na asan. We don't say sat and asat, we say na sat na asat. Sat and asat also together cannot be virodha dharmatvat. Virodha dharmatvat, because they are virodha dharma, they are opposed to each other. Kintu anirvachaniya evaiti sarva vyavahara sambhaviti bhava. As I said in the earlier pathas, once I had mentioned that for Vedanti anything is easy to explain. Once we understand what is anirvachaniya, to understand what is anirvachaniya, what is mithya, that is an elaborate process, it takes a long time. But once it is understood, then everything can be resolved into one of these three sattas and answered. Anything can be answered using the three sattas. And this mithya, they call us mithyavadis. In fact, in old granthas, if you look at tikas or some vyakhyas, the aropa is taken as mithyavada. We don't mind if you call us mithyavadis, although it is not our mayavadis. We don't mind others calling us mayavadis, because we'll use this mayavada and establish parabrahma. So we are brahmavadis really. But if somebody makes an aropa that you are mayavadis, we say that okay, it is not our primary vada, but we do use maya, which is shown as mithya. If we understand this, then parabrahma as tattva is very easy to see. Therefore, we don't mind, although it is not a right terminology, it has been used by acharyas of the sampradaya themselves to say that others call us mayavadis, it's okay. And thereby the paksha is mentioned, mayavada paksha ityadi. Although it is not appropriate, and if it is shown as with a misunderstanding, because maya they show not as magic or anything, maya they consider mithya or maya they consider as tuccha. We are not making that argument. They have misunderstood or they have misinterpreted with some dvesha or with some with some attitude issues or cunningness, outright cunningness. We don't have to agree with that kind of a maya definition of theirs, but with the maya definition as given by us, as revealed by the shastra, the mithya lakshana understood, which itself is very complex, if that is understood at a simple level also, if you understand what is anirvachaniyatvam, mithyatvam, as mithyatvam, that is fine. But it should be clearly understood. Once it is understood, then there is no issue by explaining anything. Therefore, kintu anirvachaniya eva iti sarva vyavahara sambhava iti vah. Maya sarvasya sambhavat. With this anirvachaniyatvam, mithyatvam, as lakshana of mithyatvam, we can explain anything and everything. Because we need not explain beyond that. We say it is anirvachaniya. There is anirvachaniya sarpotpatti, anirvachaniya bhranti. All this is what anirvachaniya. Similarly, swapnavat also we can use. We have no issues about swapnavat, jagrat prapancha also. Digambaranam deha parimana eva atma iti yanmatam taddusheti. Now we go into details of what they call about, what they describe this atma as all about. What is this atma all about? What kind of atma do you talk about? Because we have said pratyagatma vastubhuta. In our case also pratyagatma is vastubhuta. But in their case prapancha is vastubhuta, in our case prapancha is mithya. So what is the comparison now? The comparison is pratyagatma is vastubhuta in siddhanta, pratyagatma is vastubhuta in jaina paksha also. What is the difference? So we ask him, what is your pratyagatma described as? So digambaranam deha parimana eva atma iti yanmatam taddusheti. They say that deha, whatever size is the deha, that size is the atma. This is the swarup of atma. What is the swarup of pratyagatma as per the siddhanti? Satchidananda atma brahma nitya vyapaka anadi, all this will apply to atma. What is the size? When you compare size, we will say atma size is what? It is vyapaka tattva. It has no size that you can talk about. It is limitless. Tarkika will also say that. Some will talk about atma being anuparimana, has an atomic size. That is also not right. Logically, it will not stand scrutiny. We don't have to show Shruti as Pramana there. Where we have to show in Astika Darshana discussions and debates, we will show that. But in the case of Nastika Darshanas, logically it should be argued. Now, logical argument for why Digambara Mata of Atma being Deha Parimana, the size of Deha, does not stand scrutiny, that is being shown. Digambaranam deha parimana eva atma iti anmatam taddusheti. That the sutrakara refutes by saying evam chatma karsnyam, evam chatma karsnyam, evancha, meaning evanchet. And deha parimana atma evam, that is the meaning of evam deha parimana eva atma iti evam chet cha atma karsnyam. Atma karsnyam, atma atmanaha akarsnyam dehe, kutra dehe, dehe akarsnyam. Karsnyam is completeness, akarsnyam is not being complete. So atma will not pervade the entire deha. How so we are saying that they atma is size of the deha? Yes, atma is the size of which deha? The current deha. So Devadatta has taken a janma. He has a atma, jivatma of Devadatta is what now? It is of Devadatta's body size. Devadatta, is he born in the same size that right now you see Devadatta, who is say 25 years old? So this 25 year old Devadatta's body is different from the newborn or the 4 year old or a 3 year old, any year old. If you compare across ages, across Yavanavastha, Balavasthas, across Avasthas, Sachavasthas, the Deha is changing. If the Deha is changing, then Atma being Deha Parimana, which Deha size is it? Newborn Deha, 5 year old Deha, 25 year old Deha, which Deha size will Atma be? Obviously, when it has entered the newborn, you have to say that it is a newborn size. Now, if it is a newborn size, then as the newborn keeps on growing in Sharira, his Atma won't grow. Even his Buddhi will grow as he ages, but Atma can't grow. Will the Atma grow? We'll ask him. Then why do you say it is Deha Parimana? Then your Atma is changing. It is not changeless. Atma will become changing Atma. It will not be Nitya. It will become Anitya. That's another issue. So all these flaws will accrue once you say that Atma is Deha Parimana. Further, what? If you agree with karma, which you do, you agree with theory of karma, then what is the reason that Devadatta got this Manushya Sharira? Was he a Manushya in earlier Janma? And will he be Manushya in the later Janma if he does not get Mukti in this Janma? We don't know. Can become an ant, can become an elephant, can become Devata, can become anything. So assume that the ant Jiva is born as an elephant in the next Janma, or elephant becoming an ant in the other Janma. What happens to that Atma? Which size is it? The elephant size Atma cannot fit in the ant size Deha. The ant size Atma in the elephant size Deha will be in very minute part of the body. It cannot feel the entire Sharira also. It will feel only one part of the body, one minuscule part of the body. So all these doshas will come as corollaries. You are not making these statements, but once you analyze, then all of these defects will accrue to your system. Which claims only one part? Which claims only one part of Atma being Deha Parimana? That is the Sutrartha. Yatha ekatra viruddha dharma sambhava doshaha syad vade prasaktaha. So just like this, viruddha dharmas are not possible in one vastu, that is a dosha. Similarly, what? Evam atmanah jivasya akarsnyam parichinnatvam aparaha dosha syatyartha. There is another dosha also which will be there in your system, which is there in your system. What is that? Jivasya atmanah akarsnyam parichinnatvam aparaha dosha, parichinnatvam, limitedness of this Atma, being limited to the size of the body, Atma will be limited in nature. So won't be limitless, won't be able to expand to the size of the Deha, etc. That is another dosha. Tathacha parichinnatvad atmanah ghatadivat anityatvam syat. What is the end result of that? Bhavatu nama. So there are other doshas also there which we will talk about later, but Atma will become Anitya, says the Siddhanti to the Puro Pakshi Jaina. Atma will become Anitya, which is Anishta to you also, not only to our Siddhanta, but to your Darshan also, Jaina Darshan also. Atma being Anitya is not acceptable, not desirable. Deha Parimanatve Manushyatmanah Karma Vashad Gaja Sharire Krishne Krishnasya Atmanah Puttika Sharire Va Pravesho Nasyati Bhavah. So this example which I discussed, from the vritti itself as to this. Let's just assume he is not showing the growing up and all that, which we have seen. But the vritti says, okay, if at all, makes a very simple argument as to, because you agree with karma also, that is also refuted. That will also stand refuted if you say that deha parimana is there for atma. If it atma is deha parimana of the size of deha, then manushya atma. Let's say you give a broad size, you don't say particular size. Let's say manushya size is accepted as particular size. Even if you make that kind of argument, this manushya size across manushyas, you can say similar size is there. So we don't want to argue about such things. The kid grows up into a particular size, so that kind of atma is there. Even if we give you some concession there, still manushya and sharir of the gaja or the puttika, the ant or the elephant, that size at least has to be separated out. So what will happen? Karma vashat gaja sharire krishne krishnasya atmanah puttika sharire va praveshu nasyad. The manushya atma cannot enter the entire body of the elephant. Why? Due to karma, if the manushya jiva is to be born as elephant in the next janma, then this manushya jiva cannot pervade the entire body of the elephant. And krishnasya atmana, and if he takes the ant's body, then the entire manushya atma, manushya sai jivatma, cannot enter the puttika sharira, the ant's body. So puttika sharireva praveshu na syati bhavaha. This is the idea. So the limiting the size of the atma will bring nothing. So we'll stop here. We'll continue in the next part. Amnayantu samsiddham adhi madhyantavarjitam anandaharam apurnam atma jyoti rupasme. Namaste. Dhanyavadaha.